This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this is going to be the second video about permutations and combinations. So let's go on with permutations. Let's say that I've got three letters, B, O, B, like the name Bob. And I want to find out how many permutations there are going to be. Well, since I've got two B's that are the same, I'm going to distinguish them by calling one of them B sub 1 and the other one B sub 2. And then I could make a tree diagram to figure out how many permutations I would have. I might start out with the letter B sub 1 or O or B sub 2. If I started out with B sub 1, then my second letter might be either O or B sub 2. And if my first letter is O, my second letter might be B sub 1 or B sub 2, and so on. Now, what I've done to save some time is I filled out the tree diagram. So here's the completed tree diagram. And I've also written down all the different permutations that I came up with. And it looks like I came up with six permutations, which would make sense. There were three letters. If I have three letters, then I should have three factorial permutations. And three factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. Which is 6. But the only reason I can say I have 6 permutations is because I added those subscripts. If I disregard the subscripts, the sub 1 and the sub 2, then it turns out that I've got two permutations that are the same with BOB, and two more permutations that are the same with BBO, and two more permutations that are the same with OBB. So I've really only got three different permutations for the letters B, O, B once I disregard the subscripts. So now what I want to do is figure out a way to actually know how many permutations I'm going to have without going through this whole tree diagram. In other words, what I want to do is figure out a way to get rid of the duplicates that are caused when I have a letter or an element that's repeated. So there's a way to do that, and here's how we're going to do it. I'm going to make a fraction. The numerator of the fraction is going to be the number of elements that I've got all together. So for the letters BOB, the numerator is going to be 3, and I'm going to take the factorial version of that, so 3 factorial. In other words, if all the letters were different, I would have 3 factorial permutations. But they weren't different. I had two letters that were the same, and the number of ways I could arrange two letters would be 2 factorial. But the two letters were the same, so the arrangements wouldn't make any difference, so I want to divide out that 2 factorial. So I'm going to make that the denominator of my fraction. And now it turns out I've got 3 factorial over 2 factorial, which is the same as 3 times 2 times 1 over 2 times 1. The 2s will cancel out, and the 1s will cancel out, and I'll get 3 permutations for the letters B, O, B. Now, in general, we're going to have a formula that looks like this. Once again, I'll have a fraction. The numerator of the fraction will be n factorial. In other words, the number of elements in the set that I've got, the factorial of that number. And then, because I might have more than one letter that's repeated, I might have a number of different letters repeated, I'm going to have a number of different elements in the denominator of the fraction. I could have what we'll call R sub 1. R sub 1 is going to be repeat number 1 and how many times that element repeats. So I'm going to have R sub 1, and I want the factorial version of that, because that will tell me how many permutations of that repeat there are. If I have another element that repeats, I'll call that R sub 2. I'll call the number of times it repeats R sub 2, and I'll have the factorial version of that. If there's a third element that repeats, that will be the number of repeats it has is R sub 3, and I'll have factorial. And I could continue this pattern. Okay? So let's take a word with a number of repeats and see if we can apply this formula and make sure it works. Okay, so let's take the word sentences, S-E-N-T-E-N-C-E-S. And that's got 9 letters in it altogether. So n is going to be 9, therefore n factorial will be 9 factorial. And now let's look at the repeats. So I've got S and S. I've got two S's. So let's call, we'll say that those two repeats, those two S's, that's going to be the R sub 1. So I'm going to take the 9 factorial and divide it by 2 factorial. I've also got E. E repeats 1, 2, 3 times. So for my R sub 2, I'll have 3, and I'll make that 3 factorial. And I've got N repeating. N repeats twice. So I can put in an R sub 3. That will be 2 for the number of times that the letter N repeats, factorial. And then if I multiply all this out, 9 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 3 factorial times 2 factorial, or if I put it into a calculator, I'll be able to find out how many permutations I would get from the word sentences. Now, if I had a word with even more repeats, maybe a fourth letter that repeated or a fifth letter that repeated, I would just use this formula, but I would also have an R sub 4 and an R sub 5 and so on. So once again, the general principle works like this. Take the total number of elements that you have in your set, regardless of whether they repeat or not, and use that number as your denominator, followed by the factorial sign. So that's going to be your n factorial. Then you're going to have an R number for each of the elements that repeats. The number, the R sub 1 or the R sub 2 or the R sub 3, will be how many times the elements repeat. So S repeated 2 times, R sub 1 became 2. E repeated 3 times, R sub 2 became 3. N repeated 2 times, so R sub 3 became 2. You can use the factorial version of each one of those numbers. If you have more elements repeating, just add R sub 4 and R sub 5 and so on. And that will give you the total permutations you're going to have, taking into account that some of the elements were repeated. Okay, so that's how to deal with sets of elements that have repeats within them. Okay, so I'm going to stop this now. I'll do one more video where I deal with combinations. Okay, so stick around. I'll be right back with that.